Hey guys, welcome to the last newscast of the year produced by our yearbook staff. I'm Gabby, your editor-in-chief.
And I'm Heaven, the vice editor.
There are only 3 weeks left, and after our amazing two-week teacher walkout, things are going to get crazy.
So get your planners out now for the last 3 weeks of school.
Obviously, testing is going on all around the school in all of our computer labs, so keep quiet in the halls, and especially when you go outside by the vending machines, because there are 3 computer labs in that outside area.
7th grade tests are on Tuesday the 24th and Wednesday the 25th. 8th grade tests are on Thursday the 26th, Friday the 27th, Monday the 30th, and Tuesday, May the 1st. After that, will be makeups for anyone gone sick or in an activity.
Our fine arts program have their end of the year concerts coming up. They are April 24th, high school choir concert.
Thursday, April 26th, high school band concert.
Friday, April 27th, middle school choir concert.
And Tuesday, May 1st, middle school band concert.
The end of the year also means it's time to start enrolling for next year. Here's Georgia Princefield with Miss Elam about how to get enrolled in the classes you want. Georgia?
I'm Georgia, and I'm here with Miss Elam, our school counselor. Miss Elam, how can I make sure I get the electives I want next year?
Be sure and turn the form in that I gave you guys at the beginning of the week. And if you don't turn them in, then I get to pick what electives you go into.
I've heard some of my teachers next year are really strict. Can I have different ones?
Probably not. Teachers have high expectations, but it's not necessarily that they're being mean or strict.
What happens if I don't pass my state test? Can that affect my schedule?
Yes. If you don't pass your state testing in math or reading, you can be placed in a Title I class to get help with the reading or an ACE class to get help with the math.
Thanks for helping us understand how all this works. Do you have anything else you'd like us to know about testing or the end of the year?
7th and 8th graders are going to start testing next week. And you guys need to be sure and get a good night's rest and eat a good breakfast and be here on time, ready to go.
That's it for us. Back to you at the desk.
Thanks, Georgia. Enrollment is important. There are still some fun things going on as well. All 8th graders get to go to rookie camp at the high school on Wednesday, April 25th. We will learn all about the clubs and activities there, get a tour, and get our enrollment forms.
I can't believe we're going to be freshmen. I'm so scared.
I know. I'm going to get lost in that huge place. I just hope I can avoid the seniors.
Gifted and Talented Kids have a field trip on Monday, May 7th. Jealous.
Don't forget the 8th grade dance on Saturday, May 5th. Tickets are $10 and due to Miss Roberts by Friday, April 27th.
Color Guard will be holding a tryout meeting on Monday, April 30th, but then the clinic will be on May 7th through the 9th, and tryouts will be on the 10th. Good luck, everyone, auditioning.
That all sounds great, but I'm a little nervous about the end of the year and my grades. Here's Skylar Phillips with Mr. Jonathan with some of your announcements. Skylar? When we got no choice.
Hi guys, I'm Skylar, and I'm here with our CMS principal, Mr. Jonathan. So, Mr. D, I'm worried about I'm failing too many classes. I really be held back next year?
There's a possibility that could happen. If you fail 3 core classes or more, then you are subject to retention due to our school policy. Now, the way to get around that is you go to online summer school. And if you complete those programs, then you will get to go on to the next grade. But if you don't, then you'll be retained.
Do my grades from the first semester count to you?
Absolutely.
I've heard summer school is really hard. Do you think I can get it all done before school starts?
Yes, but it's not going to be 30, 40 minutes a day. You're going to have to work 5 or 6 hours a day. And that kind of depends on how many classes you fail and how many courses you have to take over the summer.
Is it true we can get in trouble for not trying or just clicking answers on our state test?
Well, there are some consequences for not trying. First is you could end up in a remediation class. And then secondly, especially if you're an 8th grader, if you don't pass the 8th grade reading test, then you're not going to get a driver's license. So I would say yes, you can get in a little trouble. Now, if you're going to be blatant and just click, 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 yes, then you will be assigned some discipline.
What happens if I've been absent more than 10 days this year?
Well, nothing, because you get 10 per semester. So now if you miss more than 10 in any given semester, then you will also have to take courses this summer, unless there's legitimate reason and you appeal that.
Last question. If we did something really silly on the last day of school, like a big prank or a food fight, there's nothing you can do about it because it's the last day of school, right? Wink, wink.
Students, this has been tried before. And even if you're in eighth grade, if I assign you to in-school suspension or whatever the discipline is, then you have to do it when you get to high school. And you don't want to go to high school and have to come back here to finish up in-school suspension or any other discipline. So please, please, please don't try that.
Anything else you want the student bodies to know before the end of the year?
Just on your last question, don't try that. You guys have been great. Actually, it's been a really, really good school year, and I'm really proud of you guys, and I expect great things out of you.
Thanks, Mr. D. Back to you at the desk.
Thanks, Skylar. Now we know how to make sure we are in good standing with the school by May 11th. Speaking of, our awards assemblies are coming up.
All 5th, 6th, and 7th graders will have their assembly on May the 2nd at 9 a.m. Be sure to let your parents know if you're up for an award.
8th graders have their own promotion ceremony at 1:30. I've got to remind my family so they can take off work.
I need to do that too. We will be getting awards, hearing the choir sing, and finally walking across that stage to our freshman year. Woohoo for summer!
We will wrap up the school year with our semester test. Don't even think about complaining. They have to be done.
Even classes will test on Thursday, May 10th, and odd classes on Friday, May 11th.
Make sure you're cleaning out your locker, returning your textbooks, and checking the lost and found for anything you're missing. That's it for us at CaraCast TV. I'm Gabby, your yearbook editor-in-chief.
And I'm Heaven, the vice editor. Thanks for tuning in, and
go, go Cats!
Cats! All I know is, 'cause they found new toys.